our station, our talent, and our people. You are tuned into the Startprop Property Show. Talent and our people. You are tuned into the Startprop Property Show.
Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the Startprop Property Show every Wednesday between 12 and 1 right here on Radio Eastrivier. Ons stasie, ons talent, ons mense. And today in studio, Mr. Hendricks from Hendricks Incorporated Attorneys. Good day, Mr. Hendricks.
Good day. How are you doing, Mr. Netling?
Yes, well, we missed you last week. What happened to you last week, sir?
It was the fast and I had a bit of an incident. Okay.
But we saw you online and all your comments. We noted your comments online. So that was absolutely great. yes, listeners, we're giving you a treat. We've got Rifaan Hendricks from Hendricks Incorporated Attorneys with us today. And he's our legal eagle, our legal specialist in studio. Any questions that you have related to real estate, property, homes, buying, selling, bonds, interest rates? This is the program to tune into. The Startprop Property Show brought to you every Wednesday between 12 and 1. Right here on Radio Eastrivier, live streaming across the wires, across the world. Guys, we welcome you to today's show. Every Wednesday, I'm Ivan Netling, the principal of Startprop Real Estate. And our offices are at shop number 5, Rose Center in Eastrivier. Come and pop into our offices if you want to talk about real estate, you want to talk about property. This is where it all happens every Wednesday between 12 and 1. And yes, Mr. Hendricks is here to answer any of your questions. So if you have any questions that you would like to direct, you can send them directly into studio. We can see if we can answer any of your questions on 064-536-9095. We'll get your questions aside, and we'll be happy to answer any of the questions that you may have pertaining to real estate, even with to do with estates. Mr. Hendricks, you know, today in the program, we want to talk about various things relating to property and property matters. And I'm not sure how you are experiencing the property market at the moment. Are you guys inundated with work, as the question may be, or what do you, how are you finding the property transactions out in the marketplace?
I think it's a bit stifled. The market is a bit under stress. When you talk about the market, I think in general the financial movements have slowed down tremendously. There's lots of reasons for it, but I think there's a bit of a stagnation somewhere that's not causing things to really flow like they used to.
Yes, so I think, you know, from our side, we're also experiencing real tightness in the market, if I can use that expression. And we're finding, you know, that buyers are under pressure, sellers are under pressure. You know, they want their buck and they can't get it. And so it's a very difficult market to be part of.
I think that we've been, in the past, we've been spoiled because there's been, the markets have been so vibrant in the past that we're so used to this vibrancy.
Yes.
Maybe this is the, you know, to coin a phrase, maybe this is the new normal.
Yeah, I suppose, I don't think it's a normal situation that we're in at the moment, because I think, you know, growth rates have been flatlined in South Africa for a very long time. One of the big issues that we're dealing with is the fact that there's been absolutely no growth in the market. We've seen no growth in South Africa. And, you know, the joblessness figures are, I think, running away with us. So, you know, if you look at just the economic data that's coming out there, things are pretty tight, and I think it's all across the globe. You know, I don't think it's anybody that's reporting any magic and any big shakeups in any markets. So, yes, you know, they say when America sneezes, then the rest of the world catches a cold. And everybody's been watching the Fed. Everybody's been watching the Federal Reserve in America to see which way the interest rates are going to go. And there was talk, you know, particularly in the last 2 months, lots of indication from the Federal Reserve Bank that interest rates would be coming down and that there was pressure on the government, the U.S. government, to reduce interest rates. And of course, you know, the central banks around the world take the cue from the Fed. If the Fed comes down, you know, you will normally see that sentiment reflected around the globe. But unfortunately, we haven't seen that movement in the marketplace. They've been extremely cautious in, you know, taking down values. And so that has kind of set a pace and a tone for the rest of the world, where the reserve banks around the world have not reduced interest rates. Fortunately, we haven't had any interest rate hikes, but the last movements have been, you know, keeping the interest rate the same. And I think what people are looking towards is a reduction in the interest rates to ease the burden and the pressures that are, you know, the economy is facing, and particularly, you know, people who have debt and people who have bonds. So there's a big, you know, move to look at the interest rates and see, you know, whether people can, in fact, you know, have the interest rates reduced. So this is the thing that is keeping the market under pressure, and, you know,
I don't think that's the only thing keeping it under pressure.
Okay, what is your take on the current situation as well?
Look, there's normally this flow of monies that flows through the coffers of the country, but there's been so much pilferage and so much damage that has been done over this past 10, 15 years that eventually, we're really feeling it now. And who feels it? We at the bottom. We are the tail. You know, when the dog wags, we get checked. We get checked around.
So you're saying a part of it is because of the state capture that is playing itself out now. That we're feeling the effects of the state capture and all of the other issues. So, you know, the thing is, yes, obviously, the political insecurity and political instability in any country has got a role to play, as external factors would, you know, and obviously legislation as well, also suppress the economy. And It's funny that you say that, because one of the economists was also reflecting last week on the movement of money, and also, you know, the fact that there's no growth. And what they were saying is that the amount of capital that is being attracted to South Africa, you know, people are thinking, rethinking, investing into South Africa as one of the emerging economies. And you know, one of the reasons is the fact of political stability and this thing that, you know, that has now happened with the State Capture Commission. And also, of course, you know, the fact that South Africa has run out of power. It doesn't have enough electricity to keep the lights on.
Also, a further thing, if I may add. So I'm a marketplace addict. I'm on marketplace all the time, you know, looking for bargains here and there. But when you look, one of my favorite things to search now is immigrating. Okay, I just type that in, because whoever is out there that wants to immigrate, they're selling their goodies, and they're selling it for dirt cheap, because yes, you know, if I must leave the country on Friday and I've still got a couple of goodies here on Monday, I can go there and I can give him a ridiculous offer. And then, but if you look, you must see that unbelievable the amount of people that are immigrating. So that yes, in itself also, you know, it shows yes, that they...
I saw the numbers, actually. The numbers on the immigration, people leaving South Africa is 1 million people immigrated from South Africa over the last 20 years, which averages out to about 25,000 people per annum that have been immigrating. And that's the United Nations checklist. So the United Nations just put out the report actually very recently, and they said that 1 million people immigrated from South Africa outside, emigrated from South Africa, mainly obviously to the UK but and to the US markets okay, as well.
So if you look at, if you have a bird's eye view and you see what is happening, if you look at the type of individuals that are leaving, there are people that are... Their net worths are big, okay? So those are the people that make the money, that have the fancy jobs. They're leaving because they don't see them. They don't have any value for their buck when they go on holiday. That's one of the many reasons that they're going. But we also have a lot of people coming into South Africa, okay? Lots of people.
Which is your immigration,
Immigration. But most of the immigrants are from Africa, and they're looking for a better life here.
Yes.
So it's... almost as if the motion of the flow is that
the ebbs and the flows,
guys with the bucks are leaving, and those with less money are coming in, which means happening.
Yeah, I think the one thing that's saving us obviously is that we're not seeing big immigration numbers. We're not seeing big emigration numbers. We're not seeing, you know, huge wards of people leaving. And just as you say, you know, most of the people that are leaving are professionals people, and most of them are going to the UK and obviously to the US. And then there are, you know, a few people still leaving to Australia and New Zealand, but most of them going to, obviously, to Europe. Yep. And Europe is dying. Europe is dead. I mean, to be in London today, I can't imagine anybody wanting to live in London. Their economic situation is how many times worse than South Africa. But, yeah, I suppose you have to go there and see and get bitten. But the other thing that was very good news was the amount of people that were ready to come back and resettle in South Africa. Yes. That very wealthy crowd that you're talking about, that people with the money, doctors, medical professionals, that are actually looking to come back to South Africa. And that's an encouraging tone.
And let me tell you something.
It wasn't so sunshine on the other side.
But when you look at it, I've been to, I think I mentioned on one of the programs, I've been to Bloemfontein a couple of years ago, and I did a bed and breakfast booking. I was there for 2 or 3 days. Did a bed and breakfast booking in the middle of Bloemfontein. Got it very cheap. I was wondering, why is it so cheap in comparison to other places in the country? Got there and went through the people are actually moving out of the central part of Bloemfontein. Mm. And let's say the whites are moving out of the center of Bloemfontein, and it's being bought up by non-whites.
Well, that's brilliant. Okay? That's brilliant. At least the money is flowing.
Where are they moving to? So they're not immigrating, but they're moving to security estates.
Okay, the private villages.
So those individuals that are coming back, they don't want to buy anywhere else but
into security estates. Okay.
So there's a huge demand for that.
I can tell you now, we've actually got quite a few inquiries from overseas for people wanting to buy back into South Africa. At the moment, we've got quite a few buyers from the Emirates on our books that we're looking to buy property. And then we've also got an Australian coming back, also coming to resettle. And he wants to buy a B&B for 15 million rand on the West Coast. So we've got a lot of foreigners wanting to buy back in South Africa from the Emirates and also from Australia. So they're wanting to resettle. I've also got a buyer from Australia looking for a bargain in Franschhoek. Unfortunately, there are no bargains in Franschhoek and nobody from Franschhoek are leaving anyway. So people are still seeing South Africa as a highly desirable situation. And obviously, we're the top city in the world. We're one of the top cities in the whole world. You've got a lot of people, obviously, when they, you know, lots of the immigration back into South Africa is coming into Cape Town because they see it as a desirable destination, a desirable city. I mean, we've got the winelands and all of that. So from a housing point of view and from foreigners buying back into South Africa, that's encouraging to me because it does open up the market, does open up the market spaces.
But I must tell you something as well. So I forget who the person was now, but it sticks with me. A few years ago, I was driving with this person and he said to me, oh, I think I remember who he is. He's from Indonesia or something like that. He said to me, I thought this was a poor country. So I said to him, no, we are a poor country. I mean, you know, we're up and coming. He says, we're sitting in traffic now. I said, yes. And he says, for the past 5-10 minutes, we're sitting in traffic. There's a lot of cars. So I count the value of all the cars around me. If you look at all the, just in our midst, there's more than 100 million rand worth of cars.
I'm telling you,
and that's just as I see.
Mr. Hendricks, we are our own worst enemy. We criticizing ourselves because we don't see the value of what we have and what we're living with. Absolutely. We don't understand the value. And the thing is, you know, when we grow up 20 years, 30 years, 40 years ago, we without giving our ages away, we both hit that big number this year, but without giving our ages away. I mean, when we were youngsters, how many crookies did you find on the road? If you went to town, how many crookies did you find, you know, on all the roads?
All the time, we
probably drove crookies. That old Ford Big Six, and it wasn't a crookie. I was very proud of that. But the fact is that if you look at the cars today, how many crookies do you find on the road? No. Almost nothing. It shows you that we've grown as a nation, we've grown as an economy. But again, you know, the media, we feed sometimes into what the media is saying, and the media is saying, you know, this country is like this and like that. But the fact of the matter is that people have a pretty good life, and, you know, the standard of living is pretty decent. And, you know, you can compare yourself. Do you compare yourself to darkest Africa? Do you compare yourself with other first world countries in the world? That's what I've just said to you. We had an investor, property holder, actually owns a number of properties in South Africa. And he just came back from a holiday in London. And I said, how is it in London? He said, no, never. I didn't mind going for a holiday. I will never go and live there. Things are tough. Things are very bad. So across the globe, as we were saying, you know, the economies are taking pressure. And as I said, everybody's looking to the Fed. They want the Federal Reserve to reduce rates. There's so much pressure on the American economy. They just pumped another trillion US in this quantitative easing into the economy. So I don't know what the debt is now, $33 trillion. Can you imagine, you know, living with that kind of debt and having to service that debt? So obviously, you know, the whole world is under pressure economically and we're all looking for growth. The biggest buyer, the biggest consumer of goods, obviously being China, raw materials and so on. China's just been flatlined. China has not grown in what? You know, they're in deflation where things are getting cheaper now. And you know, only those things are going to have an impact on the sale of goods. South Africa is now experiencing a glut in wine sales, you know, because the Chinese stopped drinking wine with the economies. What it is, money, what it is. And so you just imagine 1 billion people not drinking wine, how much wine surpluses there are. Absolutely. So all those things are having an effect on the economy, effect on property, an effect on how the market conditions are doing at the moment. Guys, this is the Start Property Show. Today we're talking, obviously you can hear about the economy and the marketplace and how we're finding the toughness in the market, which has an effect on prices, has an effect on buyers and sellers. And we're saying, why is everything so slow? Why is the deed office, you know, where's the transactions happening? And we're saying we need to look at broader at the economy and see what's happening around us to understand the marketplace. We're going to take a quick music break. I Wish You Joy by Selelo Selela Seleto.
This is the Start Prop Property Show. is the Start Prop Property Show.
Yes, everybody, the Start Prop Property Show every Wednesday between 12 and 1 right here on Radio Easter Fear. I'm Ivan Yetling, the principal of Start Prop Real Estate, shop number 5, Rose Center in Easter River. Welcome, guys. Come and pop in at our offices. Come and talk to us. Come have a coffee. We'd love to talk to you about real estate, about buying, about selling, about raising bonds, financing, government subsidies. Last week we had an entire program on government subsidies on the new home loan scheme. And, you know, all the opportunities that came with it, how it changed from the FLISP, the real opportunities that it represents to people who need assistance, who need government assistance to acquire that first home. So, yes, we are on this program every Wednesday talking to you about real estate. And we're fortunate enough to have with us today Mr. Rifaan Hendricks from Hendricks Incorporated Attorneys. Rifaan has been a conveyancing attorney for about 12, 13 years now. And been an attorney for about 24 years. So he's sharing and imparting his invaluable experiences over the years with us. And any questions that you want to ask us, any questions, we have an attorney right in the house. They never do anything for free. So grab hold of this opportunity. You can send through any messages to 064-536-9095. And we are happy to take your questions right here in studio. There's quite a few people that are joining us on the program today. Hi, Shireen. Hi, Carlo. A lot of people out there listening and sharing in the discussion today, Mr. Hendricks. Listening to the pearls of wisdom coming from your lips.
I wouldn't say my lips. Come on, really. Just because I wasn't here last week, now you want to.
I'm rubbing it on today.
Absolutely. Yes.
Okay, so guys, we on this program, we kind of share ideas and thoughts around real estate this morning. We're talking about how the markets are doing, and we're saying that the markets are suppressed at the moment. There's tension in the market, there's pressure in the market, and there isn't a free flow of property transactions. So hesitancy on the part of sellers, hesitancy on the part of buyers. But obviously, even in markets like these, Mr. Hendricks, you will find opportunities. In fact, you know, you need to look below the surface and you need to be looking at what opportunities exist in market spaces like this. If you are a potential investor or you're wanting to get into the property space and you're saying, wow, you know, is this a risky time for me to get into the market? Is this a good time for me to get into the market? So, you know, the question on everybody's lips is, this is a buyer's market or a seller's market? When do I enter the marketplace? And obviously, you know, in times like this where there isn't that amount of movement, there isn't a lot of traffic going through, it's a time to have your eye open for opportunities. So, absolutely. You know, Mr. Hendricks, I must say, I don't know if we're blessed or fortunate in that regard, but I have a number of investors that have suddenly stepped forward and said that they are looking for opportunities, looking for development opportunities. And I think the reason why is because there's such a pressure on the rental market. There's such a pressure on people wanting to rent properties, not wanting to make perhaps that long-term commitment to buy a property, not understanding which way the markets are going to go. So maybe they're holding back a little bit, but they're looking at the rental stock. So, you know, a lot of pressure in the rental markets. And, you know, I think people are actually paying their landlords, they're paying their rentals, you know, so that they're not going to be put out of their properties. And that's why this market seems so attractive. I don't know from your side, you know, what you are encountering from other agencies that you may be working with and other, what the talk is regarding, you know, just the patterns and the movements of investors. But we picked up a nice opportunity another day down in the Sun Valley area there for a huge property for a few million rand that otherwise, you know, wouldn't normally would have come onto the market space and things like that. So I think there are opportunities. There are some really good bargains, but you need to, I think, have a very keen eye. You need to have an understanding of how the investment opportunities work, how the investment markets work, before you just jump in and dive in and grab all of, you know, anything that comes your way. I don't know what your take is on that, Mr. Hendricks.
I think in this suppressed market, there's more opportunity in a suppressed market for investors and people to make money than there are in normal times. So if you can't make it in the worst of times, then really now, then you have to relook at your business strategy. But seeing that you mentioned that property, you have to look at and inquire more with regards to the circumstances of who you're buying from and, you know, where it comes from. So if you understand the dynamic of the seller, you you could squeeze it a bit more to get more value out of it.
Yes.
And this is the specific circumstances here in this property belongs to a trust. The properties around it are blue chip properties. We're talking about it is next to Lake Michel. I don't know if you know where Lake Michel is, but Lake Michel is, it's a housing complex for the super rich on the lake. Okay. Now everybody says, oh, the mosquitoes, the water is
pristine.
No, it's controlled and it's cleaned and it's managed and there's absolutely no mosquitoes. So that the man with a 10 million rand house who has access, who has a wooden deck access to the
lake, yes,
and he's got his small rowing boat, then he goes out on the rowing boat. He's got a 10, 15 million rand house. He doesn't want mosquitoes in his house.
No.
So they've controlled that entire environment so that there's no mosquitoes. This property enjoys the surrounding areas that is also controlled.
Yes.
There's absolutely no mosquitoes. So, I mean, 10, 15 million rand properties in Lake Michel, and this is a property right next door to it. 25,000 square meters.
2.5 hectares.
Yes, a brilliant opportunity. If I had the money, I would have bought it.
Yes, so if there's any investors out there listening to this program, here we have a massive, massive opportunity. 2.5 hectares site right next to Lake Michel, in the hollow of the Noatuk Mountains there, and you know, all offers welcome. I think they started.
But there's many opportunities like that.
I think they started off with an offer of about 24 million. That offer came down to about 12 million. So, you know, there's fair game out there. If you are looking for a pristine development that you want to get into and be part of nature, living among the mountains, what more can you want with natural bird life, bird sanctuary, and also, you know, water on your, you're part of the water.
I don't know when last you've been to that neck of the woods, but that is a huge, it's become a huge retirement, what would you call it? It's not a city, it's not a precinct, it's, Noatuk has become a retirement village.
Center, let's call it
a town. All the way from Noatuk Beach, right down to Fishhook itself.
Yes. So yeah, no, lots of opportunities.
Entire mountain sprawling with security retirement villages.
Well, that's what we're saying. In a market like this that is supposed to be depressed and suppressed, look at opportunities that are coming your way. And I suppose, you know, people are releasing properties that they don't actually need, that they would otherwise have held onto those properties. As you said, it's in a family trust. It's probably been laying there forever, and they're saying, look here, let's go to market with it now. So maybe they're relieving other pressures and so on. And so we're seeing these nuggets coming through, little gold nuggets coming through. And we have a number of them, obviously. We've got a nice development in Raithby that has come onto the market not far from this radio studio, in fact. Probably about 4 km from here, a lovely development opportunity.
Raithby
is on your way to Somerset West. Yeah, just before Fairgrove, on the other opposite Fairgrove, on the left hand side. So it's going into the mountains there. So we've picked up a nice development opportunity there with 11 service plots and one house on that property. And so a nice development, and you're very close to extremely exclusive development, Sitari Village, with obviously the private schools there and all of that. So yes, even in the tough times, in the tough economic times, little nuggets, little jewels that are making the appearance that otherwise would have, you know, people would have just laid on it, and just family land that's laying in trust in that. And so these things are now coming to the surface. So yes, Mr. Hendricks, in tough times, you know, it creates other opportunities. And so, you know, we're grabbing all of this and obviously putting it out there to the market and to our investors. We're going to take another break with Sean Majid playing a Late Night. And after that, we'll be back with more on the Start Prop Property Show.
This is the Start Prop Property Show. We'll be right back. Tune in to the Start Prop Property Show every Wednesday from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Start Prop, the property professionals.
Welcome back, everybody. This is the Start Prop Property Show. Ivan Yetling, the principal of Start Prop Real Estate. Right here in Eersterivier, shop number 5, Rose Center in Blue Downs. Please come and pop into our offices. We are more than happy to engage with you and share with you ideas around real estate, about investments in properties, around what the interest rate is doing, what the market is doing. And today in studio, Rifaan Hendricks. Welcome again, Mr. Hendricks. And we're having a conversation about, you know, various things as they pertain to the property market. And we're really looking at the impact of the economy on the way the market is being affected. And if you look at, you know, how the reluctance of people to just rush into a purchase, rush into the deals, and very, very cautious about every transaction that they're going into. But the opportunities that that market then creates for you, the opportunities that you then flow from such a market. And one of the nice things that Mr. Hendricks has mentioned here today is the fact that you need to do your due diligence. You need to investigate the transaction before you go in there. Find out exactly why is the seller selling, what is the pressure points, and perhaps there's some degree of flexibility in the deal, and maybe you can even get a bigger bargain out of that deal. So, you know, just during Mr. Hendricks and I were sharing here regarding, you know, what opportunities are really out there in the market. And I was telling him we're busy selling a commercial property in Salt River. In Albert Road, Salt River, there is a building within walking distance from the new Amazon Center. And the building is going for 3.9 million, Mr. Hendricks. Can you believe it? 3.9 million.
And the income? Rental income?
In excess of 40,000 per month.
Wow.
So that's a unique opportunity.
That's a no-brainer.
And the fact is, just come and talk to Start Prop, the property professionals. That's why we're here, to create value and also obviously to share the opportunities with the listeners and educate them regarding the market spaces and so on.
So if I may, you know, a few years ago we were talking about the fact that estate agents were punting investment opportunities to people in developments, you know, when you and what the investment was, that you buy the property and you get a tenant for the flat, and then you put a little bit extra by, and then after 5-6 years or up to 10 years, you've now brought that down. You've brought the big lump sum down, and correct, then you have then your investment is really working for you, because then you don't pay that extra in besides the income that you're getting.
Yes, no extra charges, yeah. No money from your own going into the deal, yes.
So you have to first work. So the opportunities that were available were where you had to put, where to fork money in every month. Here's an opportunity that you mentioned now, where you don't need to. Immediately, your bond is paid.
That's correct. So, you know, in fact, your rental income is higher than your bond payment is going to be. So, you know, yes, why isn't everybody doing it? And I think one needs to be aware of the fact that when you're dealing with commercial property, unlike working with residential property, the bank isn't going to give you 100% bond. So that's the one drawback, Mr. Hendricks, that yes, it is a opportunity where the rental income will pay the bond. But remember, the financial institutions are not going to give 100% loan for a commercial property. So you can only borrow up to 60 or 70% of the value of the property. And the bank is going to turn to the owner to put in capital of your own. So you're going to at least have to come in with R1 million and then borrow 2 million from the bank to get access to a commercial property. So that's the one kind of challenge that you have. But obviously, you know,
after you've gone through that,
yes,
it still pays for itself.
And the thing is, the nice thing with a bank is that, yeah, but you have to tie up for your first million. But the fact is that with a bank, you know, after 6 months, the bank will allow you to come back and reassess that portfolio. So you could typically refinance the R1 million at the later stage, because obviously there's equity in the property. If your rental income is in excess of what your bond payments are, then you're already ahead of the game. So, you know, even in the area like Eersterivier, Mitchell's Plain, Delft, there's so many opportunities that come up. Again, it's about running the numbers as an investor to buy property and then tenant that properties. There's so much opportunities. Mr. Hendricks, you didn't do too badly with your investment property that you did in Eersterivier not so long ago. You bought a property and then spent some money revamping, and now that property is, you're making a profit on their property. So you didn't do too badly as an investor, not just as an attorney, but obviously you're playing in the property space as well. So, if you want to just briefly about that experience that you went through, because it's a real live one, and I think we spoke about it on the show last year.
Yes. So the opportunity was presented via StartProp, obviously. Well, it's not that obvious, but there's various opportunities out there. So this was a deceased estate. Both mom and dad had passed away a long while already. I think it was 4 or 5 years that mom and dad has passed away. And the sisters were now interested in selling the property. In fact, because the one sister lives in the property, the other sister says, look, I'm getting nothing out of this property. I need my share. So, and that's what happens in deceased estates. The one sibling will then not want to sell, but the others want to sell because they're not receiving any benefit from it. So the opportunity started there already. Okay. Then it came on the market, but it was dilapidated. I then bought it, fixed it up, sold it, StartProp sold it as well. And it was a very sweet deal.
Lovely, man. Extremely now, that's what deal. We want to hear.
For everybody around.
That's what we want to hear, and that's what
including,
we want to...
Including the heirs. The heirs love the deal because they got more than what they...
anticipated initially. Yes, there you go. Well, you know, that's the win-win that we strive for. And I think, you know, if you can achieve that for your investors coming out, and so, you know, this program is obviously targeted also to investors. We also want to talk to investors who have looking at opportunities in the property space. You want to buy property and flip and make some money. Here's a living case. Mr. Hendricks has just gone through that experience.
But if I can just explain the whole situation. There's the estate agent that brings the opportunity. So I would not have gotten the opportunity had the estate agent not been out there on the ground speaking to the people, getting the opportunities.
Yes.
And the people are there looking for solutions.
Yes.
So there's lots of people out there looking for solutions. So wherever has a deceased estate and a dilapidated house, there's solutions for you. So you need to identify the opportunities first and foremost. And also, we do everything in-house.
Yes.
I'm talking about between StartProp and Hendricks Incorporated attorneys, we do everything. There's the estate agent that would market the property for you, number one. There's Hendricks Incorporated that will do the deceased estate for you.
The winding up of the estate.
Precisely. And we also do the conveyancing.
Yes. And the resale.
And the resale, exactly.
So that is brilliant, guys. Here we're offering you a one-stop shop solution. If you're an investor wanting to play in the space, wanting to come into the property space, here's an opportunity for you to come in and have a chat with StartProp. As Mr. Hendricks said, everything in us, we can manage a property from the time we identify the opportunity till the time it goes back into the market and you've put some cash in your hands. Obviously, there is a risk with everything, but you know, we can talk through the risk. We can identify what those risks are. And against the facts, against, you know, an experience of a track record and a history that you've actually done this thing successfully, we can actually achieve outcomes together and have that win-win situation.
Absolutely. But now you see the nice thing about this is, as the opportunities come along, like there's at least half a dozen opportunities that I am busy with now.
Yes.
Okay. So if another half a dozen must come along, I won't be able to reach out for that. So there are opportunities that we can present to other people who have the appetite to want to do, to play in this space.
Yes. No, that's fantastic because, I mean, that's what we're about, is obviously creating value for people as a real estate company and to share that knowledge, share that experience, everybody become part of the process. So, you know, you don't have to be on your own. You can come in as a team. You know, the bank is prepared to give a bond to a number of people together who can buy together and enter into the space to do some property developments, flip the properties and see a return on investment. So guys, there are lots of opportunities right out there. Come and chat to StartProp. We're at shop number 5, Rose Center, in Eersterivier, right opposite Pick n Pay. We're ready to talk to you, engaging with you, even in these markets, even in these challenging markets, we have opportunities and that we can, you know, really turn the opportunity for people, whether it's property developers or people just wanting to speculate and, you know, turn a profit with houses. We're going to have another song now. Sylvia Mandujelwa playing Mudube.
You are tuned into the StartProp Property Show. are tuned into the leading internet radio station in the mother city. Station, our talent, and our people. Tune in to the Startprop Property Show every Wednesday from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Startprop, the property professionals.
Yes, welcome terug. Welcome terug, mensen. Mr. Hendricks, did you enjoy Sylvia Badanjelwa?
Yes, that was nice.
The lion sleeps tonight.
Yeah, that was a nice take on it.
We are in Africa, and today we're talking real estate right here on the Startprop Property Show. Guys, we hope you're enjoying all the jazz. We try and bring some local jazz artists together with property information every week during 12 and 1 on this show. And we thank you for being part of it and for, you know, sharing the ideas and sharing the thoughts with us. So if you have any questions that you want to pose, you can always send it through. We'll get those questions and answer them next week, 064-536-9095, right here in studio. Mr. Hendricks, so we're looking at opportunities, we're reflecting on the market, and we're saying that even in, you know, depressed markets or markets that are seemingly very tough, there are opportunities that arise. And obviously, you just need to be wary, you need to be cautious. And then secondly, do your due diligence properly, do your homework properly, look at, you know, can I squeeze the buyers, can I squeeze the sellers, how does the opportunity work, where is there, you know, opportunity in this deal? But I think what we've proven is that, you know, through your very personal experience of entering into the markets in East River, where you could get an estate, the property was in a very bad state. The house was not a well, how can one say, with a good reputation. I mean, they were using the house for all sorts of illicit means. And you saw further down the line That, you know, if we clean up this property, restore the property to its you know, former glory, if I can put it that way, spend some money on the house and bring it to market, you could actually make some money on that property. Mm. And you know what looked like a nightmare or a disaster actually turned out to be a good story for all the parties, including the heirs. Mm. As you said, you know, they had inherited the house. And, you know, they at the end of the day got more than what they expected for their property. And I think that is the win-win that we would be talking about in markets like these that are challenging, that there's still money to be made in real estate. So, guys, if you are thinking about getting involved in the property space, wanting to make money on an opportunity, come and talk to us at Start Prop, the property professionals. We are at shop number 5, Rose Center in East River. Anybody doesn't know where Rose Center is? Directly opposite Pick and Pay, the entrance of Pick, the new Pick and Pay in East River. We're there. Come and chat to us about your properties, about making money, about making opportunities. Also, you know, about the new housing finance loans, the new housing finance schemes, where you, if you've, you know, you can, government is prepared to subsidize the building of your first house. Prepared to give you a subsidy towards buying your own property, coming into the marketplace up to 169,000, as long as your income is between 3,500 and 22,000, you qualify for all these subsidies. So there's a lot going. There's a lot of exciting news in the real estate space, and we're asking you to be part of it, be part of Start Prop, and be part of this program every Wednesday between 12 and 1. Mr. Hendricks, thank you so much for coming to share this time with us.
Always a pleasure.
I know we are on the other side of the half of the fast, and I think we're ticking down. This is the holy week. I think the last 9 holy days of the fast. And
if I may, I think next week Wednesday is Eid, so I might not be here next week.
Okay. I hope I'll whisper to the moon. It must make its appearance on Thursday. Then you can be on the program. So you can fast a full 30 days and not 29 days. But we'll see how that goes. But I know it's your sacred time. It's your holy time, this last 9 days. Of the fast, where you guys contemplate on the more nobler things of life. But even in those times, we can also, you know, just be understanding that, you know, through Start Prop, we can put families into homes, we can empower people with knowledge about the real estate, we can show people that there are subsidies, how to get bonds, how to improve your lifestyle. You don't have to be a backyard dweller. You don't have to be sharing spaces with others. You can be a homeowner on your own, even from the rent to buy, to getting the subsidy going. So there's so much opportunities. Come and talk to us, Start Prop, the property professionals out in Blue Downs in shop number 5 at Rose Center. We're welcoming you. Our phone number is 061-4600-259. 061-4600-259. We're happy to share this time with you. We see you back next week, maybe with or without Mr. Hendricks. It may be La Barang, or it may be non-La Barang, last day of Ramadan. We'll see. But Mr. Hendricks, whatever happens, enjoy the feast, enjoy your family, enjoy this time, the sacred month.
If I may, I don't think it's a time for feasting if you look at what's happening in Gaza.
Yes, no, the people are suffering out there and losing their lives. And yes, that's the inhumanity of man to man. We haven't grown, we haven't learned in all these years. So
it's amazing how insensitive people have become. We're in the 21st century, and we're so insensitive. Unbelievable.
Well, you know, I thought we would have migrated from just being animal instinct to being human. But the humanity is obviously sadly lacking.
And this is from first world countries. I'm not even talking about South Africa.
Yes. So, guys, we are signing off on the Start Property Show this Wednesday. And we hope you guys have had a great time with us. We've enjoyed the program. I hope you've enjoyed it as well. Ivan Yetling, the principal of Start Prop Real Estate, until next week, Wednesday. And we're playing out with Sure All Stars, Langre.
Tune in to the Start Prop Property Show every Wednesday from 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. Start Prop, the property professionals. Thank you. are listening to Radio Easterover.